Good morning. I am your host, Big Ed Mustafa, and this is Lotro Stream. I woke up this morning, thought I'd check to see what was going on Twitch and maybe throw somebody a host. Turns out,
good morning,
nobody is playing
Lotro.
I am your host, Big Ed Mustafa. I need to mute myself. Although I sound terrific, so I'm excited about that. Anyway, since nobody else wanted to play Lotro this morning, I will. And I'm just going to pop on Galandriel, my 105th level champion, run some Minas Tirith dailies, and maybe see where things go. So, if you're up enjoying a bowl of cereal, or if you're in Europe and just starting to think about what to have for dinner, welcome to the stream. We'll get things launched. First, we'll start off with a delicious, crisp, cold Coke Zero. Always important. Not an official sponsor of Big Ed Mustafa's channel, but it probably should be. Man, I've got a lot of junk. Who takes shattered spears? This is the new task item turn-in station in the housing area. They all have them, and it is spectacular. If you don't like doing daily task turn-ins, this simplifies it immensely. From my standpoint, I need to use it regularly just to keep from drowning in my own loot. So I like it from that standpoint. And since I've got about 10,000 shattered spears, this will at least help me get rid of maybe 2 stacks of them, which would be a good thing. And I'm getting some item experience, because, you know, I'm just desperate for extra relics. But task item turn-ins help you with your faction rep. It helps you with your item experience. There's titles. There's cosmetics that you get. The cloak I'm wearing is the cloak of the hotshot. It's the cloak you get after 500 task turn-ins, which doesn't take as long as you might think. You should try to do task turn-ins every day if you can. Believe me, it really adds up. In fact, at 100th level, task turn-ins are worth almost 25,000 experience apiece. If you have 10 task turn-ins in a day, you're talking about 250,000 experience points just from task turn-ins. Believe me, when you're trying to get from 100th to 101st level, an extra 250,000 XP is pretty nice. And there we go. I think that was number 10. Task item turn-in limit hit. So, I just got rid of 100 shattered spears. And let's see what the hobbits are sending me today. A massive pile of silver. 2 gold worth, nothing wrong with that. Thank you, hobbitses. Okay. Let's go see what our friends in Minas Tirith are up to today. Nobody ever watches me, honey. That's part of the fun of streaming. I can sit here and just say any crazy thing that pops into my head and not worry about offending anybody because nobody's watching. And we're in the happiest place in all of Middle-earth, Minas Tirith. It's the city that never sleeps. Okay, if that's the main gate, I need to go over here.
Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in better days. The enemies of men approach. I hope you are prepared. The enemies of men approach.
Yeah, we're gonna start this off by wandering around lost inside the cisterns for a while. Hi, CableNet. Hi, Master Roger. I am on Arkenstone at the moment, playing my champion. I also play on Crick Hollow and Brandywine pretty regularly, and I have tunes on Gladden and Landrival. Although I will confess they're not played that often. Yeah, it's bad enough you have to worry about all of the troops pouring out of Mordor coming to kill you, but dying from lag death would be also frightening for the folks in Minas Tirith. CableNet has a very valid point. I hope you guys are having a good morning. Too many alts, not enough time. I didn't want to go that way. I'll just stop here and anything that's chasing me dies. There we go. Why are you not facing the right way? Okay. There's a lot of stuff in here today. ironic I'm scrambling to find the door out just so I can turn around and come back in. Hey, it's the door out. I shudder to think I might actually be learning my way around inside of here. Days on web, howdy! Thanks for coming by and checking out the stream.
Every minute feels like hours. We can only prepare so much.
Does every minute feel like hours? Can you only prepare
every
so much?
Every minute feels like hours. We can only prepare so much. Every minute feels like hours. We can only prepare so much. We won't let our city fall. Every minute feels like hours. We can only prepare so much.
Will you let your
we
city
won't
fall?
Let our city fall.
Are you sure you won't let your city fall?
We won't let our city fall.
All right, if you say so. Seem pretty insistent on that fact. Hi, Del 7. Good morning. I have managed to defeat an orc. I'm excited by my progress. Orcs are like potato chips. You can't just kill one. You have to kill them in bunches. Ooh, a piece of rubble. Constant Rager, howdy. What do you get from these dailies you're doing? I get Minas Tirith rep. And unfortunately, you need ungodly amounts of Minas Tirith rep. I'm kindred with the entire world except for the Ale Association, the Inn League, Heroes of Limelit, or Limelight, and the Defenders of Minas Tirith. And I got 48 of 60. And I guess there's another tier after this. I don't even know what the rep is for, other than I'm not maxed out. And if I get all 600 billion rep points, there might be a title. Yeah, I had somebody comment a couple weeks ago that they don't see a lot of LOTRO streamers on their level cap characters. And it's because, you know, it's not that exciting to play a level cap. And if you're out doing raids and stuff, maybe it is. But, you know, logging on my champion just so I can come out and grind through the same dailies 45 days in a row for whatever reward I don't even know is at the end. Not that exciting. You know, I was on the stream last night for about 5.5 hours. I was running my burglar Little Ed Mustafa through Moria, got a bunch of quests done, put up a couple levels, actually got out of Moria and got into Lothlorien for the first bit. I'm going to have to turn around and come back into Moria, which is fine. But, you know, I mean, there was stuff to do and things to accomplish. And it was just, you know, not daily grinding. But this is what you have to do at level cap, so here I am. I've got a 103rd level hunter that I could be going back and backpedaling on deeds that I skipped over previously, but that doesn't sound like much fun either. I've got some other alts I could be leveling up, but, you know, looks like... I mock his power. I do. I mock you. There. Everybody come here and I'll just kill you all at once because I want this rubble. Oh, that's nice. But there's a Runekeeper or a Lore Master in there just setting everything on fire. To come in right behind me. I saw lightning, so that's Runekeeper. Okay. Yeah, Spider Pig. I have the most fun at the mid-levels. I think 40th to 60th is really... And that's where I've got bunches of characters in that level range. You have the most choices. I mean, when you're, you know, 40th level, you've got Misty Mountains, you've got Forakel, you've got Angmar. You can go to any or all of them, do whatever you want. And then you've got Moria, which is just, you know, this huge, wide-open playground where you can go do whatever you want. On Aragion before that. And then after Moria, you can either go on to Lothlorien and Mirkwood, or you can go do Enidwaith and Dunland. You've got the Great River. It's a lot of stuff. And then once you get out to Rohan, I like Rohan, and I think I might like Rohan more than most players. I mean, it's a nice change of flavor after creeping around dungeons and slinking around Mirkwood. You know, being out in the open and riding the war steeds, and even if you don't like mounted combat that much, I mean, just to have that vast of an expanse to cover, and you've got four different regions of Eastern Rohan, and you can do all of those simultaneously if you want. And it's all open. I mean, they're not even different zones that you feel like you're porting around, but they're all like four sections of the same giant zone. And, you know, it's all open and it's all sunlit and there's tons of things to see and do and quests galore. So, I mean, Rohan's pretty rockin'. But, you know, as you get higher and higher in level, all of a sudden that choice, that variety kind of shrinks back down. And it's like after you hit 75th level, it's just Rohan. There's not really much else you can do. And then Western Rohan, and we're off to Gondor. But I mean, the saving grace for the upper levels is that you can stay in an area as long as you want or move on as quickly as you prefer. Because from my experience, I mean, getting from 75th to 105th level really isn't that hard. You just kind of keep following the quest packets and follow the epic storyline, and you'll get there faster than you think. It's one of the reasons my hunter's backtracking so much. I got kind of bored with Rohan. The problem I had was I had been through Rohan really recently with my champion, and kind of took my hunter into it probably too soon without taking a break. So when I got back there, everything felt like been here, done this. So with my champion, I just kind of breezed through it, and as I leveled up, just continued moving on quickly rather than going through all of the quests and content. And now I have to go back and finish up some things. Goat Chucker, who refused to do Morion Goat and walked the entire way. That is hardcore. I'd stream Occupy South Bree Fence. To stream failing the same raid over and over until you barely beat it. Yeah, that's not exciting. Do you ever go two-hand champ rather than two one-hands? And is there a reason? You know, it's kind of a feel thing. One of the reasons why I tend to dual-wield is just because of timing. It feels faster to me. And, like, if you're fighting the half-trolls that are all throughout Gondor, they have a big stun, but they wind up for it. And I like using hamstring to disrupt them. And I feel like with dual-wield, I can throw it more quickly instead of waiting. I do have a two-handed sword that I carry. It feels a little slower, but one of the reasons that I carry it is I actually prefer it for mounted combat. When I'm on my war steed, I do like to go with a two-handed weapon. And it hits harder, and when you combine it with the fury bonus you get from your war steed, it does very bad things to your opponent. But I'll go two-handed weapon here for a little bit. Also, the most basic reason to go dual-wield instead of two-handed weapon is if I have two-handed weapon, like with this sword, it's got some great bonuses, but my one-handed sword has all kinds of great bonuses, and this sword has all kinds of great bonuses. And if you carry two swords, you get the bonuses from both swords. If you go with a two-handed weapon, you only get the bonuses from your two-handed weapon. So, more weapons equals more buffs. Well, it looks like we're all kind of on the same content at the moment. Yep. He tagged that one, I tagged this one. Fortunately, I tagged the one who just decided to leave, so good for me. Shing shing faster, there you go. Well, to the developers' credit, they weren't going to spend all that time developing mounted combat and not make you at least try it. But also to their credit, by the time you get to Western Gondor, or rather Western Rohan, I mean, mounted combat is pretty much optional. I mean, there aren't very many instances of forced mounted combat once you get out of Eastern Rohan. So the damage output penalty for dual wield really isn't very high. Both weapons do a tremendous amount of damage. And like I said, the faster attack speed combined with more buffs, it's like, why would you not go dual wield? One of the many reasons to dislike the cisterns under Minas Tirith is it's a public instance, so we're all in here creeping around, fighting over the same mobs and kills, and all trying to find the same stuff. And it's fine, like, with the rubble and the papers, we can all pick it up, but like with the Withering Tree NPCs that we have to find and fight, if one of us taps it, the other person can't. So I'm going to have to go back through here and try to find the Withering Tree folks 4 and 5 times. So... this is an area where I'd prefer to have it all to myself. If somebody comes running around through here the same time I do and they take those Withering Tree NPCs, they can take a while to respawn. Berg-mounted combat on release was, Lutz. Yeah. I can believe that. There's that Lulz. Lulz. Hi, Wolf Howl. Welcome to the stream. Your champion should never struggle. At no point in my 105 levels playing a champion have I ever thought, wow, I think my champion might be underpowered. I do occasionally get confused when I can't tank 12 mobs at the same time. But, yeah, it's... either there's something with your equipment or your traits or your virtues. I was talking about the difference between playing a burglar and a champion, and I kind of like the challenge of playing a burglar because you kind of have to think your way through quests and things. You can't always just run in and overpower everything. Whereas playing my champ is like taking a chainsaw to pudding. It's very messy, it wipes everything out very quickly, and it's a lot of fun. So... we should figure out what your champion needs in Moria to not struggle. Hi, Sylphid. Welcome. Thanks for coming by. Not know you guys had an official Twitch channel. Here we are. Trying to catch up on chat real quick. Yeah, Runekeeper is definitely different. I have a 59th level Runekeeper that's deep into Moria. They're a lot of fun to play. Setting things on fire is always a good time. Yeah, 10 mobs is no problem on a yellow line champ. I don't remember. I think I've got yellow line traded. Oh, I have a point available. Who knew? I am traded for yellow line. I almost never play yellow line, so I probably won't play it here because I don't really know how. That's one of those things that I'm... you know, Lotro is a constant learning experience. I've been playing the game pretty steadily for 4 or 5 years, and I'm amazed at how I'm still learning to do things and still working some things out. And it's just... it's a little bit like... Go or Chinese checkers. It's easy to learn and difficult to master. But one of the things that I had to learn for the first time recently, thanks to CableNet, was yellow line burglar. We have an all burglar kinship on Brandywine called the 40 Thieves, and we go out and we run 3-man and 6-man instances with all burglars. So we use, you know, fellowship maneuvers to heal and some different dorky stuff like that. But nobody in the group knew yellow line burglar really much at all. So we were trying to figure that out. And, you know, it's hard to believe that after all the time I've played the game and Little Ed Mustafa, I think, was my third burglar. And I'd never played Yellow Line before. So it was like going out and learning a new character class, even though I have two other burglars. CableNet was immensely helpful with that. Thank you very much. But, you know, my champion, I've got a 105th level champion here. I used to play a little bit of Blue Line and switched to Red Line and haven't really played Yellow much. She hasn't done a lot of group content. And do I need another lieutenant? I do need another lieutenant. Perfect. So going out and learning Yellow Line on this champ would be something else that would help me be a better champion. Okay, so all the lieutenants are down. Somewhere there's a big crack in the wall. Looks like somebody came along and cleaned this all out for me. Lieutenant Dan, you got new legs. He's still coming. All right. We're going to turn this Urukai from Lieutenant Dan into Lieutenant Dangle. And that's blocked. That's the other problem with the cisterns. You can't even leave yourself a trail of breadcrumbs because the damn lizards will eat them all. It's very frustrating. Can you fight Saruman in this game and Sauron? You definitely can fight Saruman. We haven't gotten to Sauron yet. Those will be some future add-ons. We're expecting, or rather I should say we're hoping to see Minas Morgul and Moria in future updates. At least in instance play. We'll look forward to that when you do, CableNet. We'll be glad to have you. But yeah, there's a whole series of instances in Isengard where you get to battle Saruman and go through Orthanc, and matter of fact, one of the regular storyline quests, you end up as a prisoner in his dungeon for a while. Yeah, Sauron is the eye in the east, the head bad guy, although guy I don't think is technically correct. He's of an elder race of, somebody geekier than me is going to have to fill in some gaps here. I wish I could rattle all that stuff off the top of my head, but it's too full of useless Rolling Stones trivia and things like that that aren't pertinent to Lord of the Rings. So, Sauron's not a man, but he is the man who made the ring, if that makes any sense. And then Saruman the White was a wizard who turned against the free peoples and decided to cast his lot with Sauron, seeing Sauron's power is inevitable. And one of the cool things about Lotro is you get to see almost everybody. You get to talk to Gandalf, and you get to walk alongside Frodo and Rivendell, and you get to meet Elrond Half-Elf, and you get to talk to Boromir, and you get to meet the... drawn another blank. The Steward of Gondor. And Galadriel, whose name I ripped off so brazenly. Just threw one extra consonant in and voila, Galadriel. Planning on keeping this game up for 5 more years. Yeah, it's one of those things that I'm a long way from being tired of the game, that's for sure. Like I said, I continue to learn. I continue to find things I haven't seen before. And, you know, the latest updates and the latest content that Turbine has added to LOTRO, they're actually making the game better. I mean, we've gotten more textured detail in the graphics, and some of the new cities they've added are just gorgeous, and the quests and the regions, and I mean, there's stuff that I don't like. One of the regions they just added, Farinorian. It was this knotted hills covered with tree roots, and it was hard to travel and annoying, and you know, the quests were interesting, but it was so obnoxious trying to get around on the landscape to get it all done. But I liked the music. And then at the end of it, it's like, all right, I'm about tired of this stupid region. When is this going to be over? All of a sudden, they end it with the Battle of Pelennor Fields, and it was the most spectacularly epic cinematic piece of the game I've ever seen. I mean, until you play it, you don't really have an appreciation for how great it is. And it's like, you know, here it is. The game was released in 2007, 2009? 2007. And it's 2016. The game's 9 years old. And the developers have just dropped the single best piece of content, in my estimation, in the whole game. And it's like, wow. I mean, anybody who played LOTRO and left the game even up till a year or two ago has no idea how good it is. Just since Farinorian, Old Anorian, Minas Tirith, and the Battle of Pelennor Fields has been added. I mean, it's really, really cool stuff. I was up here before, but did somebody else get my follower? No. Okay, this is all cleared up. There's one guy I gotta go find. This is why that public instance is so annoying. I'm going to be backtracking over everywhere I've been trying to find him. Some parts are dead. Yeah, Corey, the Tolkien professor, was just on yesterday, and he pulled like 65 viewers. That was pretty cool. People tell me the game is dead, but I still love it. Yeah, it's kind of funny. Every game is dead. I mean, from the minute they release it, the game is dying. Dying is just a natural part of the life cycle. But, yeah, in the case of LOTRO, it's a long way from being ready to be buried, I can promise you that. You know, the server consolidation has kind of boosted the population on the remaining servers. There's a lot of people who are doing pickup groups and going through group content that they haven't seen before for the first time. And and if you heard that in the background, that's Mrs. Mustafa sneezing. Bless you, Mrs. Mustafa. Yeah, there you go. Sauron is Malar. I knew it wasn't Valar, but I couldn't remember the other one. Yeah, when the game's 9 years old, I mean, you don't pull in tons of new players. I am on Arkenstone currently. The 10-second battle frenzy build, I have not. Hi, Ninth Pawn, how's it going? I have survived the Cisterns of Minas Tirith, which means I can actually go do something slightly more fun now, so. Of the three before battle daily instances, the Cisterns are my least favorite. The other two I
won't let our city fall.
Can't say are fun, but I enjoy them a lot more. We'll ride our goat. Lotro is one of those games that makes you think a little bit, and one of the things I like about my champion is if I'm not in the mood to think, I can just hop on and go destroy stuff. And these next two sets of dailies, that's pretty much all that's required. Just going out and wrecking a bunch of orcs and a bunch of easterlings and setting fire to stuff and breaking things, and it's a good outlet. Yeah, Turbine's always been really good at creating rich, detailed, unique game worlds. And the job they did incorporating
these are all of the, times indeed.
The book and movie lore into... Where's the main gate? There we are. Incorporating all of that lore into the game world and fleshing out the game world. To me, Lotro is almost unique in that I haven't played an MMO where the game world itself is more than just, you know, a series of leveling zones. Asheron's Call was very well tailored as well. It was a unique storyline. It was something that Turbine had created themselves. And it wasn't, you know, World of Warcraft is a great game. I mean, obviously very popular, 10 million plus subscribers at its peak. And, you know, Legion's getting ready to come out. It'll be hugely popular again. But, you know, a lot of World of Warcraft, a lot of Warcraft was borrowed from Tolkien. A lot of other MMOs, EverQuest borrowed from Tolkien. And to have a game that doesn't just borrow from Tolkien, but takes Tolkien and fleshes it out and creates a whole game world based on the books and follows it faithfully and is true to the storyline. You know, sure, do they embellish a little bit? Do they add some things, you know? The Earthkin come to mind, or the idea of having playable Bjornings, having Bjornings all over the place, when I think there were very few left in the world at the time of... even the Hobbit, the Bjornings were extremely rare. You know, I mean, there's some things that may not be 100% kosher, but nothing that's really lore-breaking. It's not like we've got motorcycles to ride around on, or we don't have dwarves shooting guns, or things like that. I mean, and it's just, it feels like a real world, you know. You feel the distance from the Shire to Minas Tirith. I mean, they're so far away, and the landscape is so huge, and they've just really created a world, and it's a lot of fun to adventure here. It feels like a real place. Yeah, Omega Femme's got a point. The only reason Lotro's not attracting new players is, you know, it's a 9-year-old game and there's, you know, they're not doing expansions anymore. It's not like there's going to be anything in stores to go by. And it's tough from a marketing department. It's a marketing standpoint. It's tough to push a 9-year-old game. That's kind of, you know, my role as a Lotro stream member, I feel, is to try to showcase the game and to try to attract new players. Or at least bring back players who'd given up on the game and thought, well, there's not going to be much more to see or do here. I have the graphics pretty well cranked up. I'm going to take a look around here, and I want you guys to take a look with me. Just blow this up full screen. Look at Minas Tirith. Look at the job they did creating this city. I mean, it is freaking amazing. It is beautiful. This does not look like a 9-year-old game. And I was talking before about some of the graphic enhancements and the more richly detailed textures. You know, I'm standing here in this huge city that I just rode up and down 4 or 5 stories of. And, you know, there's ash in the air from Osgiliath burning off in the distance. And there's statues and plaques. And there's the pier of Minas Tirith looming large above me. And, I mean, just the scale of everything and the idea that, you know, you see that the top of that pier way up there, and I can go walk right up there right now. There's, you know, nothing preventing me. It's pretty cool. I mean, is it the most complete game graphically? You know, I think Final Fantasy XIV and, of course, ESO probably look better from a client standpoint, but I don't know that they necessarily play any better. Oh, I'm going, why can't I read the quest text? I need to turn my user interface back on, or that doesn't show up.
I hope you are prepared.
I am prepared for the enemies of men, but thanks for asking. And I got too much stuff again. Alright. Don't need that. Don't really need that, but it's in the bag anyway. Don't need that. We'll take those. Oh, good. More broken, shattered spears. I was afraid I might run out. That wasn't the direction I wanted to go. I'm just spinning in circles now. Michael, delving to the Hornburg is a run of about an hour and 20 minutes, yeah. Legendary paperweights. Yeah, legendary disposable trash would be a good description. You can jump off the pier. Hi, Nettlebrew. Thanks for coming by and checking out the stream. Nettlebrew is a fairly new Lotro streamer. Is that safe to say, Nettlebrew? But if you get a chance, give Nettlebrew a follow. You can just left-click on Nettlebrew's name. It'll pull up the dialog box, and you can just click the heart button to follow. And then Nettlebrew will show up on Twitch whenever he's streaming. You can go check him out. If there's any other Lotro streamers in the channel, feel free to say I stream, and we'll try to get you guys some follows too, because, you know, like I was saying, we're the marketing department for Lotro at this point. The only way people are going to know to try the game is if they see us streaming it and they stop in and ask questions, and we can say, yeah, Lotro's still alive. Yeah, Lotro's a great game. Yeah, Lotro's got bunches of new content. Yeah, there's a big active Lotro community here on Twitch, and come join us. All right, what am I going to mail away here? We'll send Nemone some shattered spears. I'm sure she'll appreciate that. Nemone is my 103rd level hunter. I don't know that she needs shattered spears, but I need pack space, so that's what we'll do. More zircons. And Lenorian is my 78th level minstrel, who's also a scholar. So we'll send her some scholar junk that she doesn't need. Actually, I really need to log on Lenorian sometime and just craft a whole mess of scholar stuff just to burn up some crafting material. She is choking on it. The crafting material, that is. Oop, I forgot that scroll. Alright. So let's switch to two-handed weapon. Let's jump on the war steed. Now we're going to go tear some stuff up. Cable Knit would rather lurk than stream, but that's okay. If we were all streaming all at the same time, there'd be nobody left to watch, so... You know, there are some days where I have more fun hanging out in other people's streams and chat than I do streaming myself. Streaming takes a little bit of energy. By the time you get Moobot going and Twitch alerts and you're dealing with your OBS settings and you're trying to watch your stream and follow chat while you're playing the game, it's a little bit like air traffic control, I imagine. I haven't crashed any planes or caused innocent passengers to die, but I've sure wrecked my own stream a couple of times through negligence, so I know what that's like. We'll get a look of Minas Tirith from the landscape. I mean, it's just... Holy crap, is that cool! And then Osgiliath burns off to the north. And Osgiliath is really cool in a completely different way. The forces of Mordor have run through it like Sherman through Georgia. And there's dead bodies everywhere. It's on fire. Buildings have been completely destroyed. The place is infested with enemy troops. But at the same time, I mean, it's just graphically beautiful. And there's tons of stuff to see and do. Lots of quests, lots of fighting. It was not difficult at all to complete. Yeah, it's a Fellowship Warband. I don't think I'm going to try to solo that. I am dumb enough that I do tend to try to solo small Fellowship Warbands. Turbine wasn't so distracted with cash grabs, we could have some new things that would keep the game alive. I think that's an unfair assessment. Omega Femme, I've confessed to being a longtime Turbine fan since I played Asheron's Call and their first MMO. And I even have, I shouldn't say even have, like it's some kind of, problem to actually play Dungeons & Dragons online occasionally. But Lotro's got the best free-to-play model of any game I've ever tried. I mean, I'm a free-to-play player. I've got characters at level cap. I've got all of the content open. You know, about the only thing I can't do is swift travel, get my mail out in the landscape, and I don't get 500 turbine points a month, but I wonder if this guy's going to repeat himself, too.
When the time comes to fight, we'll be ready.
Will you be ready when the time comes to fight?
Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in better days. When the time comes to fight, we'll be ready.
It's my first time in Minas Tirith. Yeah.
Shame you couldn't see it in better days. The enemies of men approach. I hope you are prepared. Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in better days. When the time comes to fight, we'll be ready. Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in
You know, and I think of game developers, and developers, it's not even... The developers aren't normally in charge of cash grabs. Publishers...
The enemies of men approach.
That's a different story.
I hope you are prepared.
So, if you feel there's something about Lotro that is a cash grab, I would point that more towards Warner Brothers rather than I would towards Turbine. You don't create a game like Lotro without putting some love into it. I mean, it's too well crafted, it's too faithful to the original lore. The people who were involved in making this game and the people who were involved with continuing to develop this game clearly love Tolkien. I mean, they love the Lord of the Rings. They're slavish to the game world. They're slavish to the original storyline. And, I realize part of that's contractual, but even then, I mean, this is just, it's very faithfully done. And the reality is, Turbine is not a not-for-profit organization. Warner Brothers is definitely not a not-for-profit organization. These guys need to make money, and LOTRO needs to make money. Otherwise, you know, there's no point. You know, they're not out to publish LOTRO and keep it up and running just, you know, so that we all aren't out shooting pool and, you know, getting into trouble. They need to make a buck. And I think Turbine's been very fair about not letting that become the main focus, but just trying to develop a good game in a way that makes folks want to keep playing it. You know, VIP 3 months for $30 is money well spent, speaking as a person who doesn't pay it. You know, I wouldn't hesitate to recommend going VIP to anybody. It's just a great balance of there we go. I hit him for just about 12,000 points on that first swing. So yeah, champion on heavy Warsteed is a happy thing. Guard is slower but tougher. You get no audio. Hi, Sargeras. Yeah, minis go pretty fast. I'm trying to catch up on stream really quick. I'd stream, but I refuse to look at Mubot. That's going to hurt Eldalus' feelings. If I stream, people would wonder how I play with 3-second freezes all the time. Other bots are available. I've tried to stream, but the stream was a slideshow. Hunters are pretty flexible, Wolf Howl. If you just want something to roam around on and try a lot of different content, that might be fun. Sargeras, I have no idea why you're not getting audio. Seems like the stream's going good. People are responding to my speech. So hopefully you can get that sorted out. Yeah, guards tend to open up a little bit at the mid-levels. I've got a couple of, I've got a 51st and a 659th level guard. And I like playing my guards, but it's after they get a couple of area of effect attacks. I play redline. And mostly solo again with the guards, which isn't what guards are designed for. But once you get a couple of AoE attacks and you can kind of throw those in, it makes having to tank, you know, two or three orcs or two or three goblins at a time a lot less tedious. Because while you're fighting the first one, you can at least be chipping away at the second and third, and it makes them die quicker. Now, the key to warfare in Middle-earth is vandalism. I'm burning their tents, because if I burn their camping gear, it demoralizes them. It's all part of our road to victory. Yeah, I would be remiss in not recommending a champion, is if you just want to create a character that can go anywhere and do anything and accomplish small fellowship quests solo. Champions are very flexible and very powerful. Played burglar too much to play a good guardian. I bleed out so fast on my baby guard. Yeah, I'm like Nettlebrew. I've got at least one of just about everything. I don't have a Bjorning, and I'm not going to say never, but it's not anything that interests me a whole lot. When they announced the new class, it was like, really? I know a lot of people are playing and like them. And more power to you. That's what's great about LOTRO. We've got choices. You, come here. We're gonna fight this guy. There we go. Oh, I've still got the two-handed sword equipped. I hadn't noticed. Nothing wrong with it, obviously. It still gets the job done. Stupid archer. Okay. And really, the key to any good character development is going to be fishing. Fish a lot. It's important. You know, Ninth Pond lives in Florida. He can confirm this, but anytime you see shipwrecks, that's really a good spot for fishing. The fish tend to congregate around them. Six-pound salmon, delicious for dinner. We can smoke it, maybe slice them thin into lox. That would be delicious. Goes great on a bagel with cream cheese. If you play on Arkenstone and you need any fishing trophies for your house, please let me know. I have some, and I can spare them. Brandywine as well. Hi, Maiden. How's it going? We're just doing some fishing. I caught a goldfish here in, wherever the heck I'm at. This wrecked harbor. Alright, one more cast, and then we'll get back to killing things and breaking stuff. I'm doing pretty good. My Bjorning dies, it's because I wanted her to, yeah. Here, fishy, fishy. Here, fishy. Carp. Proof that nobody at Turbine actually fishes. This is the most prized game fish in the entire game. Supreme cook ingredient. There's a restaurant here in town that actually cooks fried carp. It is some nasty stuff. I've heard if you smoke it, it's not so bad. And unfortunately for me, Mrs. Mustafa likes fried carp, so she drags me down there to eat once in a while. Fortunately, they have catfish and walleye and some stuff that isn't gross, so... And it's... I eat weird stuff. You have to... when I say it's gross, it's not because I don't like fish. It's because it's gross. Hi, Mr. Troll. Ah. There we go. He did not make it. Dazon's doing some cooking. Hopefully Dazon is not cooking carp. I would not want to have insulted Dazon's meal. But I like the chances that none of you are cooking fried carp at the moment. Well, not trying to be rude, but there's only so many trolls, so... I don't want somebody else clearing them out before I at least get a crack at them. Thank you, Maiden. That's very nice. Nobody wants to follow my stream, though. Basically, the reason I was added to Lotro's stream is so I can make all of the rest of the streamers look that much better. People will come by when Maiden of Rohan is streaming, or Eldolith, and they'll be like, oh, thank God, Big Ed Mustafa's not on. This is so much better than watching him. Hi, Nardaga. I'd probably already killed Nardaga once. I gotta go find the other captain. I always have the tough time finding all the tents for some reason. They're giant and green and they glow when you haven't already set them on fire, so I don't know why it's such a problem. For some reason I always end up wandering through here trying to find the last tent. I'd much rather do than be wandering around looking for the last withered tree follower. That's far more aggravating. Hi, Mr. Troll. Hi, Zims. How's it going? Made that orc mad when I shot him with an arrow, so I'm gonna run away. I want to burn this tent. Like last night when I was in Moria, I got the last statue piece. And like I said, victory is measured in vandalism. We burn their camping gear, they wreck our statues. It's more like fraternity pranks than warfare. Three tenths to go. Solved the audio issue. My son had microphone plugged into the audio jack and vice versa. Yeah, I've never done that before. CableKnit has never tried a champ and she dreams of Hobbit champs. Hobbit champs would be cool. Hobbit Warden is pretty cool. Sounds like I own stock in Cabela's. I'm not sure where Sauron buys his tents. It's a good question. Tents and trolls. It's a good thing. We're all burning the same tent, killing the same orcs. Am I done with trolls finally? I am done with trolls. There's actually two different troll slayer quests that pop up. One of them's to kill 6 trolls and one of them's to kill 8 trolls, so even when you think you're done with trolls, sometimes you still need one or two more. The Hobbit Warden is pretty boss. Well, the good news is I'm not going to have any trouble finding orcs to kill, so not particularly worried about that quest. Oh, there he is. Those guys just rode away from one of the lieutenants. One of the captains, rather. So, captains are dead. I just need orcs. Orcs are easy. Out of here. Actually, Spider Pig, given my fishing tendencies, I'm more of a Bass Pro Shops kind of guy. That's actually true, too. We have a Cabela's and a Bass Pro Shops both here in town, and I go to both, but I tend to favor Bass Pro Shops. Probably because I like the restaurant in it better than I like Cabela's. Like Maiden, I'm afraid it mostly comes down to food with me.
When the time comes to fight, we'll be ready.
3 meals a day if I can get them. All right. Oh, good. More shattered spears. Hate to run out of those. Hi, Princess Quill. Yeah. Bonus dream is correct. I did about 5.5 hours last night and was playing Little Ed Mustafa. Got him up about 2.5 levels. He's 59th now. And got through most of Moria and got a chance to peek his head out into the sunlight. That was nice. So he's actually in Lothlorien, but probably needs to go back in. There's just a couple of zones inside of Moria I haven't done yet. Foundations of Stone being one of them. I got tons and tons of quests done. I'm kindred with both the Iron Garrison Miners and the Iron Garrison Guard. So Moria's feeling like it's pretty well finished up at this point. I'm an insane OCD completionist, so at some point I'll probably have to go back through there. If you have a problem with being an OCD completionist, either a burglar's a really good choice or a really bad choice. Because trying to go back and do Slayer Deeds Advanced on a burglar is just incredibly painful and grinding. I mean, it just really sucks. So, like with Galandriel here, I went and did them all. And the idea of doing that on my burglar just doesn't compute. I'm like, no, there's no possible way to do that. Sargeras, before GPS maps, I knew directions based on restaurants. With my wife, I have to use malls. Where are we going? It's over by the Oakview Mall. Oh, that she gets. If I say crazy things to her, like it's north and east, she just looks at me like, why are you talking in a foreign language? And then she'll do stuff like, do you know the Super Target over on 170th and Center? I don't like Super Target. That's not the point, honey. I know you don't like Super Target, but that's what it's by. Yeah, I don't like Super Target.
The enemies of men approach.
Do the enemies of men approach?
I hope you are prepared.
I'm prepared, but do the enemies of men approach?
We can only hope that the Rohirrim will arrive before it's too late. Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in better days. When the time comes to fight, you'll be ready. We can only hope that the Rohirrim will arrive before it's too late. Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in better days. When the time comes to fight, we'll be ready. The enemies of men approach. I hope you are prepared.
Somebody was just up here clearing this. What's nice about this instance is there's nothing really up here on the rampart that I can't get down below. There's going to be plenty of Easterlings to kill, and there's going to be plenty of supplies to grab. So if somebody wants to run along up here and clear it before I get to it, not a big deal. I just have to get hooks and posts, and I'm good to go. It's weird that that warrior didn't hear me hacking his friend to death right behind him. You, come here. There you go. And even if you didn't like the guy, I mean, they probably carpooled together once in a while. It'd be one thing if he was annoying or chewed his food too loud at lunch, but why would you let me murder him? Not even try to help. Guy probably had a wife and kids, and now they're going to be like, why did you just stand there while he was being hacked to death? I didn't want to get involved. Hi, Olip. How's it going? Yeah, how much black do I have to wear before I look slim, Olip? I don't think there's that much black in all of any store ever. Black is the new black. Shualar warrior was probably just standing up here looking out over the river thinking, this is really nice. I can't wait until I muster out, maybe buy a little farm, and oh wait, there's an elf with a couple of swords behind me. Then boom, it was too late. That's a lot of horsies on the top, bro. It is a lot of horsies. But I have a lot of horsies, and if I don't put them on the toolbar, then I won't ever pick them to ride them. So I figured I may as well key a few up. I also have a very fancy cat. I want to get your guys' opinion on the very fancy cat, because I feel like maybe I'm being unfair. I had some pretty high expectations. I wanted one of those Blofeld-style Persians, you know, like the villain in the Bond movie always has. What is it, Himalayans they're called? And this is what I get. This is the very fancy cat. It's a nice cat, don't get me wrong. But let's, I need to go the opposite of zoomed all the way out. Is the cat fancy enough? I don't know that it's that fancy of a cat is all I'm saying. I mean, it's kind of gray with a little bit of white and a white-tipped ear and maybe a little white-tipped tail. If it just said fancy cat, if it said nice cat, okay, but very fancy? I mean, I'm thinking Himalayan, I'm thinking diamond-studded collar. I'm a jeweler. I could have made the diamond-studded collar. Or even a zircon-studded collar. I have the zircons. That just doesn't seem like that fancy of a cat to me. That's all I'm saying. I mean, it's a nice cat. Very fancy. We'll let him follow around. You can just... The only thing he does for me is he meows in the background while I'm killing stuff. It's like, yes, cat, you're very fancy. Yeah, and I'm not trying to dog on the cat, no pun intended. It's a nice cat, but is it very fancy? I don't know. Now, it's always important to check that end section of wall down here. And I'm just going to run back here for the heck of it to show you where I'm talking about. But one of the captains will sometimes be stationed right here. So if you don't come all the way down to the end of the wall here, you might miss him. But he often spawns down below too, so we're going to go find him and fill him full of sword holes. So at this point, I think I just need captains and supplies. You can hear the cries from that very fancy cat. He is not here. So we'll ice these two clowns. Yeah, we'll ice this clown too, just because we're here. Sometimes one of the captains spawns there at the end of that bridge. Sargeras is exactly right. It's very confusing. It's supposed to be a fancy cat, but he's asking for Meow Mix. I feel like they oversold that cat to me. Like they had the expectations here, and the cat's really here. It's a nice cat, I'm just saying. And Maiden, All Up, Ninth Pawn, anybody else who's feeling chatty, I did fire up my Discord. So if you want to pop in and talk rather than type, would love to chat with you. If you want to just hang back and watch and drink coffee or eat a bowl of cereal, I understand that completely too. Well, I think it's getting to be about lunchtime. Not that Mrs. Mustafa would know. She went out to shoot football pictures last night at one of the local high schools, so she's all tuckered out. She's still laying in bed. Not the least bit concerned about the fact that I had to go get my own Coke Zero this morning. Crisp and refreshing and delicious Coke Zero. But hopefully she'll wake up by the time I need a refill. Come on, fancy cat. There's got to be some cat food and catnip and cat treats in some of these supply crates. Can't believe the Easterlings would travel without cat supplies. Just seems crazy, especially since they're the folks with the battle cats. It's an interesting question. Why are there no battle cats here at Minas Tirith? Inquiring minds want to know. Oh, okay. I saw the white text. I was hoping it was one of the captains. Can't believe I haven't seen either of those clowns yet. I've got other people on landscape. They might be murdering them before I get to them. Nope, here's one of them. Kaskar. Kaskar, meet Fancy Cat. The harbinger of your doom. In Old Anorian, the last sound you hear before you die is meow. Fancy Cat will not rest until every Easterling is dead. No, Ninth Spawn, having to get the Coke Zero myself makes it taste not as good. I didn't think about that. Gothrog may be allergic, so they kept all the battle cats home. That's an excellent point. Okay, just need to find this last stupid captain. Commit war atrocities against him. Okay, I just killed you, so stay away from me. Sometimes the other captain's just kind of out here in the middle with all the troops. Really? You know, I hadn't thought about this before. We were talking about the difference between yellow line and red line champion. And anybody else who's played some champion, I had previously confessed to not having played yellow line a lot. Those area of attacks seem a lot slower to me. Like, I don't feel a difference between one-handed and two-handed weapons when I'm doing the area of effect attacks. So it's quite possible that two-handed is as good or better for area of effect or yellow line, and that maybe dual wield just feels faster when I'm on purely red line attacks. Anybody has any thoughts about that who's played a champion, let me know. Hi, Dazon, how's the cooking going? Where is your stupid captain? Stupid thrower. Fancy cat, you should have warned me he was over here in the bushes. Hi, Fruka. The cooking is done. It's going to be sunny here, too, because after I get done with the before the battle dailies, I switch over to the after the battle dailies. First, I need to find that stupid captain. Oh, captain. Captain. Fancy Cat and I want to do very bad things to you. Where are you, Captain? I already killed him. That is not the captain I wish to murder next. Kaskar is the captain who sometimes spawns up on the wall, so I was looking for him there. But Hurusana? He's usually always down here somewhere. I'm a little annoyed he hasn't popped up yet. There he is. Come on, Hurusana, let's get this over with. I got stuff to do. Plus, you're holding up Fancy Cat's nap. Don't step on the caltrops, Fancy Cat. We ain't got time to visit the vet today. Alright, so that's how much fun that is. Hobbit hype. Hobbit love. Hobbits for the win. I thought it might be fun to make a hobbit hunter that was a yeoman, so he had farming and cooking. It's kind of a shame that hunting, being a hunter, doesn't give you any access to food. You know, like if you killed a coney, you got a rabbit carcass. Something like that. I guess they figured.
Is this your first time in Minas Tirith?
You know, extra access to cooking ingredients would be too overpowering or something. Not sure exactly what the logic was there. It is a shame I couldn't have seen it in better days. Hey, I've got great news for you all up if you're still in chat. I caught a carp, and it's on Arkenstone, so I can't mail it to you. Unless you want to tell me one of your characters on Arkenstone. Actually, Galandriel here, among her many other fine talents, happens to be an Anorian master chef as well. So she is maxed out. And knows exactly what to do with the carp. Let's see what the carp cooking recipe is. I think that's a master recipe. Campfire. Trail food. We got flounder. Is that a supreme fish? Really? Trail food. Roasted carp. So you need one carp. Green peas, a lump of butter, and a pinch of mixed herbs. So I'd have to grow some peas to cook this. But the roasted carp gives you plus 33 vitality, plus 33 will. The fishing recipes themselves are actually pretty potent. Even at the apprentice level, where I think the fish of the day is dace. Fried dace with mushrooms. Boom, plus 4 vitality, plus 4 will. That's a pretty big boost for an apprentice level character. I mean, you can eat that at level 5, level 2. So, you know, if you're starting out with a budding lore master or room keeper, you know, even fried dace with mushrooms is pretty handy for trail food. They were the only foods early on that actually gave you stat buffs, too. So not only should you fish, but when you catch fish, you should cook with them. It's good things will happen, as far as I know. The carp in game is a cooking ingredient. Yeah. No fishing allowed. He's a fat dwarf, RK. Sure. Client crash. Sorry about that, everybody. It happens with Minas Tirith occasionally. Failed to start the game. Game's already running. If we're already running, I wouldn't be trying to start it. Failed to start the game, app already running. I promise it's not. Failed to start the game, app already running. I think it finally figured out the game's not running, so we should be good to go now. I am feeling lucky. Olop's gonna be right back. Gondor needs your help. Kill it in the task manager. It died soon enough, Cervantes. Good suggestion, though. What's interesting about the fishing is that, like, it's the only cooking ingredient that you can't farm or buy. You have to go out and catch fish in the wild, and it's very random. You could, if you wanted to cook carp, you could go fish for an hour and not catch one, and then you might pull three or four in a row. Not in a row, but in short order. So, like, if I wanted to make a bunch of dace with mushrooms with 200 fishing skill, I would have to go to some very specific fishing spots to try to catch dace. It would be rare for me to catch one. But like the fishing pond in Stock? Or the water near, I don't even know if, I've never fished near Archit. That's a good question. I know there's water near Archit, but you don't get fishing until after you leave the area. So I've never thought to go back there and try fishing. Staddle is where I was thinking of. The fishing pond in Staddle, I could probably catch dace if I went there, because it is a beginner's fishing area. This outfit is Terry Adwin approved, I'm happy to say. It's the cosmetic version of the Heligrod Dragonscale armor. It comes in red naturally, and I've got it matched with the Hotshot cloak that you get for doing 500 task turn-ins. Needs more yellow. You know, Terry Adwin did not mention that to me when she saw the outfit, so I'll have to let you hash that out with her. I know Terry Adwin hates the tracksuits on Brandywine. She refuses to wear one. And I've thought about, just for fun, it would be cool to have a yellow tracksuit. But I can't get that Shire Plum dye to re-dye it back if I wanted to change it. So I probably won't do that.
Is this your first time in Minas Tirith?
Amusing though it would be.
Shame I couldn't see it in better days.
It is a shame I couldn't see it in better days.
Time comes to fight.
Thanks for mentioning that. Because I hadn't thought of that before. Hunt for buried treasure. Oh, and just in case you're keeping track at home, I've got a blonde sorrel horse, a steed of the Dusk Watch, not sure where I got that from, a Lossath steed, steed of the Eastamnet, steed of the Horse Lords, Festival Azure horse, Elf Ambassador's horse, Grey horse, Prized Angmar's Free People's Horse, Prized Thorin's Hall Goat, Eriador Horse, and my war steed, Thunderhoof. So, we have completed all of the pre-battle dailies, and I'm going to pop over to Minas Tirith after the battle. Why not put it in the shared wardrobe? It is in the shared wardrobe. I have to carry it around with me because I don't have enough storage to put it anywhere else. You can see all of the pieces here in my inventory. I also haven't been able to bring myself to ditch my Armor of the Sea Reaver. It's actually still pretty good statistically, even compared to the player-crafted Anorian armor I'm wearing. And it took so long to grind out that armor. The idea of just selling it or throwing it away kind of sickens me at this point. So it's a little bit like my Amiga 500. I bought a computer for when I was in college back in the very late 80s, and I still have it sitting in a storage bin behind me. Because I remember writing out the check and my hand shaking because it was the biggest check I'd ever written at that time. And the idea of just taking that Amiga 500 and throwing it in the trash, it's like, no, I can't do it. So that's kind of how I am with my Sea Reaver armor. I need to leave. I think it's this way. Nope. I think it's this way. There we go, to Minas Tirith. So they have a phasing versions of the city. You can be here before or after the Battle of Pelennor Fields. I have transitioned from before the battle to after the battle. And when you get to after the battle, I was going to say the skies are sunny and bright, but it appears to be nighttime now. So at least they're starry and bright. Ironically, ash doesn't seem to be falling from the sky now, even though Osgiliath is probably still on fire, as are parts of Minas Tirith. So the kicker is there are some new dailies on this side of the phasing. And if you do them and complete them all, it opens up different instance play. And I'm wondering if anybody in chat knows whether or not the third instance has been added to the game yet, and or what I need to do. Yeah, order confirmed. Yeah, I've been long accused of that. We've been joking about me having... one of these days I'll just get an invite. Hey, Ed, we're going to go do some raids. You want to join us? And then I'll get there and it'll be like, yeah, this isn't really a raid. It's your intervention, Ed. We're all concerned about your hoarding. I have a lot of crap socked away. Aiding Minas Tirith, Hands of a Healer. I am old. I am an old, old man. CableNet says it wasn't added when they did the update, so... Okay, that's too bad. Sifting for survivors, routing the lurkers. I'll just go up and see Aragorn and kind of play it by ear. Although what's actually nice about the post-battle is just about every service you need is right here by the city gates now. You've got vendors to sell stuff to. You've got Relic and Forge Masters. Yeah, this is going to take a little bit. My apologies.
What news do you bring, traveler?
I just am really tired of legendary weapons. Horn damage, Brutal Strikes damage. Love hamstring duration. Bracing attack. Always handy. Galarian has told me that I'm crazy and that statistically speaking, and he has run the numbers, I believe that, equipping your horseshoe when you're breaking down legendaries has no effect. But I just wear mine anyway. It's a superstitious device, so I may as well be superstitious. 50 out of 60. Here's a 60 out of 60. Let's deconstruct that bad boy. Bracing heal, dire need, merciful strike, fight on. We'll do bracing heal. Nothing to do with it. Okay, what else do I have to burn down? This club. A club of the third age. I think that's it for now. My problem is, like, I don't know if you guys can see the text on screen. I have over 500 of every single tier 1 relic. If we go to tier 5, I've got 70, 80, 90 of every tier 5 relic. Even tier 9s. Okay, I don't have a bunch of tier 9s. That's good to know. But I've got enough relics that if I wanted to sit here and piss away all of my gold, I could sit here all day clicking buttons. Don't really need them, but I can't stop myself from continuing the grind.
What news do you bring, traveler?
I don't have any spares that need to be identified. Good. Let's see what we can sell to
Gondor
the provisioner.
Needs your aid.
The silver scraps can go. That still seems useful to me. I don't know there'd be a big jump up with the major essence of incoming healing. I'm keeping the carp. I'll add it to my housing chest. I am greedy for carp. Okay, well, I've got cooking and tailoring, so if I have any other cooking or tailoring scrolls, I can pick them up. I don't. I have the other four. So I'm going to need a mailbox. Let's do... poop. Sell so I can grab that. Alright, that'll work. Let's get me to a mailbox. Mailbox is right here. See how much more convenient it is? I feel like the forces of Mordor did us a favor by improving service availability here in Minas Tirith. You used to have to look all over for vendors and mailboxes and forge masters, and now they're all right here at the city gate. Send that off to Lenorian. And what else we got here? One of the problems I've been running into with the Zircons is if you pile up enough of them, they're valuable enough that it starts to make them expensive to mail. Right now I'm at 8 silver. If I add all those zircons, it puts me over 100 silver just to mail them. I'll get them out of inventory, though. I don't really need them, but the problem is I'll just end up starting another stack. Cooking scroll. Audrafina is my runekeeper. She's 59th level, and she's also a tinkerer. I have not played her in a while. I might have to dust her off and stream with her sometime. Although, since I play runekeeper only occasionally, I don't know I'm that great of a runekeeper. Other runekeepers might not want me streaming her. You suck. Quit trying to show people that's how you play a runekeeper. I get that a lot. But that's it. I'm not carrying a lot of stuff for hunters. I don't even have any hides, do I? Nem gets those. What was it I missed? Oh. Shinaria is my guardian. She's 51st level. And Mirabella is my burglar on Arkenstone. She's 54th level and in Moria also. I think those packs are about as clean as I can make them now. Except for the carp. That'll go in my housing chest. In the event of an actual emergency, I have enough food stored at my cottage to sustain me almost indefinitely. Where's I going? Up to level 6. Okay, thank you for your patience while I weeded through all of that. Nettlebrew, enjoy the Chinese food. Have a good one. Yeah, most of the people, well, I can't say most of the people, I'll speak personally then. If somebody wants me to craft an item for them at level 100 or 105, and they supply the materials, I'm tickled to do it just for the chance to do the crafting. You know, you spend a lot of work leveling up your crafting and getting it there, and then a lot of times it feels like you hardly ever use it. You make yourself one set of something and you're set, and it's like, I wish this was actually more useful. I know some of the crafting stuff, people are able to make extra money with it, but I don't know who. I haven't figured it out. So after the battle here, we're at the High Hall at the Houses of Healing, and there's all kinds of notable people hanging out in here. We've got Gandalf, who's watching over Faramir. Faramir was severely wounded and almost dead. He lays here with Mithrandir guiding over him. Also laying in the Houses of the Healing, Merry and Eowyn, and both of them have been overcome with darkness since Eowyn ran her sword through the face of the Witch King of Angmar. I've mentioned it before on stream, but that's one of the reasons why Galadriel and most of my main character line here on Arkenstone are all female. Because if you're going to play a game called Shadows of Angmar and the Witch King can't be killed by men, then play a woman. So, I have plenty of male characters, but... Hands of a Healer. Some King's Fill has been found, but it remains to be seen if it was enough. I may need someone to help me as I move from bedside to bedside. Will you be that elf? Sure. Even though we know you'd rather have Arwen here. Let us see if Faramir's condition if approved. Remain alert in the event you are needed. Now we go see how Eowyn is doing. He's basically taken Kingsfoil and made like a Vicks VapoRub Middle Earth version. Yeah, I don't see Eowyn popping up out of bed here. She stirs. That's pretty awesome. Walk to Mary's bedside. This Kingsfoil is good stuff. See how Mary's doing.
Ned, this is your tummy talk. Please slow down on the Coke Zero.
Never.
And no Taco Bell at 1 a.m. Please.
Oh, amen to that.
We put off a lot of gas.
You said this is your tummy speaking, right? As Mariadoc sat up and said he was hungry.
What's up, brother?
It's good to see you again, Galandriel. Do you remember when we crept to see Theoden's War Council in the Drudan Forest? It feels to me as if that was years and years ago, but it cannot have been. I have been caught in a terrible dream, but already the memory of it is fading. I think supper will be just the thing, and afterwards, perhaps a pipe. I don't think I will ever smoke again. Theoden was sorry he would not be able to speak of herb lore with me, smoking our pipes in comfort and peace. I will never be able to smoke without thinking of him. There we go. It's weird to see Gandalf running. Completed instance, the hands of a healer. Talk to Gandalf in the high halls of the House of Healing. Hey, old man.
Look pretty slim in that black shirt, buddy.
I do. I look kind of almost gaunt and, like, undernourished. Oh, good. Another Farinorian essence box. I'll add it to my other pile of Farinorian essence boxes. I don't have any armor to put the essences in, and I don't have any storage to get them out of my inventory. So that was good. Are we sure that that's not the third instance there, Cable Knit? That seems to have wrapped it up all rather nicely. Oh, and I'm 3,000 away from the next level of Minas Tirith.
Spin around there. Let me take a look at your gear.
Look at my what?
With a G. Gear.
Gear?
That guy's mad.
I didn't catch that. What'd you say?
Looks good.
Thanks. I was saying earlier it's a Terry Adwin approved outfit. Cable Knit said it needs more yellow. Thank you. Generally, anybody who's sitting up is not affected with the black shadow. They have to be unconscious. I hadn't thought about it, but...
Is this your first time in Minas Tirith? Shame you couldn't see it in better days. The enemies of men approach. I hope you are prepared. We can only hope that the Rohirrim will arrive.
Go away, you well-wisher. Nobody wants you here. You can only complete 4 of these dailies a day? But there's no reason to not take them all and just finish the first 4 that you can. Plus, of course, I get confused and finish like 10 of them and then go to turn them in and can only turn in 4. And then I'll probably get real salty. It's a weird quest mechanic. Hey, all up, have you thought about trying something new, like maybe playing a burglar on Brandywine or something? Where'd he go?
I'm not going to respond to that.
Okay.
He's up to 40, almost 48.
All right. Hey, visiting well-wisher. Get out. I like the Well-Wisher's quest because it's like fish in a barrel. They're all over the place. Easy to chase them away. Mort! Hi, welcome to the stream. Mort was just cutting grass. Ninth pawn is in Moria Goblin Tipping. Little Ed is very close to Goblin Slayer Advanced in Moria. Time's your pool party all up. Shouldn't you be getting ready?
2 o'clock.
2 o'clock. You got about an hour. Nothing wrong with that.
Yes, sir. Come on now, everybody's
welcome. Come on, Minas Tirith.
Four cup zero in that chair. I'm telling you, you need to figure out how to get you a little tap next to your computer.
It would help. It would help. Wife finally woke up and went and hopped in the shower, so if I run out now, I still have to go get my own.
The enemies of men approach. I hope you are prepared.
Are you here to help?
I am here to help. Better living through chemicals. Another one of those patients with a hidden gold ring. Gotta watch out for those. Thank you. mixing table. Dazon still gets lost in Bree. I have to admit, I think I feel like I've got Bree down pretty well. I don't brag about too much, but I generally don't get lost in Bree very badly. Now this Rohirrim is messed up. Mort is running to the store, back in a bit. Don't forget to pick up some beer for the pool party, Mort. Maybe a bag of chips. Anything else you need? All up, you want him to get some ice?
Ice would be good.
And some ice, Mort.
We're all maybe gonna make some Chaco or something, that'd be great.
Yeah. If we're going to come down and crash your pool party, then at least we can do is show up with stuff. Mort already has beer. Is there like a guard captain or somebody here I need to see, or I was just dreaming that? I was just dreaming that. All right, I did fish a little earlier. Let's see if I can fish this fountain. Where's the fishing pole? There it is. Yes, this fountain is fishable. I am fishing in the Halls of Healing in Minas Tirith. Come on, 50-pound salmon. That was weird. That's a mechanic I have never found in game before. I can fish the fountain, and I'm catching fish and reeling them in, but it doesn't give me any fish. Nothing goes in my inventory. I'm not catching any trophies. Interesting. Who knew? Normally, if it lets you pull out your fishing pole and cast your line, you catch something. Not afflicted. He looks like he might be afflicted. Nope. This guy's definitely not afflicted. Oh, somebody was afflicted. You the king. I dreamt the king had come again. Nope, Elvis is not back. Sorry, you were hallucinating. Yeah. He has the black shadow. Tiram Redbeard. Marker placed. Alright, hopefully that's enough to finish the dailies. I'll go back and turn them in and maybe be done. It's kind of a catch-22. I don't really want to grind them all out, but at the same time I need the rep. Otherwise I'm going to be coming back here doing another 30 days worth of dailies. That kind of makes me want to hurt myself with a fork. Hi, Shoto Elite! Oh, what time did I get on? 10:30 this morning? Central. I've been on a couple 3 hours, maybe. House of Remedies.
About time to crack a beer.
My wife just asked if somebody was trying to kick me off the stream because I'm doing a bad job. She has a lot of faith in me. Nobody knows I'm doing a bad job, honey. Nobody ever watches when I stream.
You got 30 people in here, man. It's nice.
Shh, don't tell my wife.
She'll only worry about our relationship.
Yeah, that's what the main thing. I don't want her to come over and look and find out I'm talking to all up in ya. Yes. My wife is convinced that all up in ya and I are having a torrid affair with one another. When really, we're just burglaring buddies.
That's right.
I have failed a bunch of quests, which is fine with me. And I am still... ...2100 points away from the next level of Defenders of Minas Tirith rep. Somebody told me that even after I get it, there's another tier above that that requires 90,000 rep points to complete. And I have no idea what's at the end of the rainbow for that. Maybe I can look. Class Race Epic, Eriador, Gondor, Farinorian, Deeds, Warbands, Treasure, Lost Trail, none of the above, Oldenorian.
Yeah, the burglar made a statement didn't help our arguments.
That statement did not help my argument that we're burglaring buddies.
Yeah.
Yeah, Maiden says Big Ed and Olive's relationship is something we should all worry about. You're not alone, honey. Maiden of Rohan is worried, too.
She's just jealous. It's okay. We'll let Ginger's in the group, too.
Race and social, roving threats, while your head hurts, epic, reputation, honored in Minas Tirith. must earn standing. I get 30 Minas Tirith silver pieces, 20 turbine points, and a title, Esteemed in Minas Tirith. Yeah, that sounds like it's well worth the grind. Alright, 20 turbine points it is. After the battle, completed the Hands of a Healer. Oh, I actually did finish something. That was the third instance. Yeah. That was nice. I just wandered into Aragorn, and there it was. Hands of a Healer, 5 turbine points, 5 Minas Tirith silver pieces, increased rep. And, yes? Oh. One moment, I need to take a 15-second wardrobe break.
Uh-oh, was there a sharding accident? Come on in here, Doc, for sure, me. I'm in our Discord,
No, there was no sharding accident, and since you are my boyfriend, Olip, I will not mention to Eldolith that you said sharding on Lotro stream.
You just repeated it, sir.
We gotta keep it classy. Or something. Well, now here's the problem with being 105th level. I just completed every possible daily that I can. I literally have nothing else to do in Middle-earth at this point, at least not on Galandriel. So I'm gonna pop home. Okay, this is exciting stuff, guys. If you haven't seen this before... yeah, we're Maiden's father. I forgot the hierarchy tree of Lotro. That's blurry. Am I blurry? I naturally look blurry, so if you think I look blurry, that's just how I look. That's not your monitor.
I'm not sure I'm a part of that father thing. I think I'm part of the guessing or something.
So, this is what your cottage looks like when you're an awesome fisherman. Sturgeon group trophy, darter group trophy, trout group trophy, 50-pound salmon, another sturgeon group trophy, another darter group trophy, bam, another trout group trophy. So, I just have some stuff laying around. And here is the master stash of fish. I currently have 143 carp. Now 144. One of these days I'm just going to sit down and cook all of this fish. In the meantime, it can sit here in the chest on ice and be good to go. Oh, you know what? Thank you, Pookie. Mrs. Mustafa was kind enough to reload me.
Tell her hi from Olip.
Olip says hi, Pookie. That's why, no matter how hot the passion runs between me and Olip, my wife isn't worried about it because she knows if I told Olip to go get me a Coke Zero, he'd tell me to get it my damn self. That's why it'll never work out between us in the long run, Olip. Oh, what was I going to do? I have a place to stash all of this extra stupid armor that I don't want to be carrying around, finally. The Sea Reaver stuff looks cool, too. I just like it. One of the changes they made when they changed housing an update or two ago was I noticed that when I was poking around my cottage, all of a sudden I could buy a lot more housing storage just for in-game gold. I didn't have to use turbine points and I didn't have to use mithril coin. So I went ahead and loaded up and it doubled the space of my housing storage without having to use up anything I would consider more valuable.
That's nice.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that. And I'll put Farinorian essence boxes in here. Well, trust me, any chance I get to buy storage, I usually jump on it. I mean, if you don't think that's going to make a difference in making my life easier, you have no idea. Crops, 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 crops.
Probably open up those essence boxes. You can hardly just find them by value. You can say two boxes for the six.
I guess that's it for now. Wow, they want 100 mithril coin to upgrade that space any further. Still not too shabby. So if you were a 105th level champion all up and you had maxed out all of your dailies, what would you go do next?
So are you all the way through the epics and everything?
As far as I know, yeah. I mean, I did the Battle of Pelennor Fields, and which was freaking awesome. Have you done that yet?
Yeah, I don't think I've gone all the way through, so it's pretty cool.
Yeah, other than some of the group content, I don't think I've missed anything.
Why don't you try to do a solo six-man or something?
Yeah, I was doing some... a series of duo instances on tier 2, that was kind of fun, but I can do them all. I have to screw up or not notice I'm losing health to die. Although, what was it? I was some of those. Anything that reflects damage is bad for a champ.
Oh, yeah.
So I can pretty much take anything the game can throw at me except my own damage output.
See how fast you can go through Halls of Crafting solo.
That doesn't scale, does it?
No, just run it at whatever it comes up.
Greetings.
I think it's like 58 or something, right?
Yeah, probably. I think most of the Moria instances are. I think that's going to be it as far as junk I can put away.
It took me like 20 minutes on my captain, and I really wasn't putting all my trial on his hands.
I think it's great that you're continuing to play your... gimped out weak-ass captain instead of getting a champion like you probably should. Much better character class.
I've already got a 105 champ.
I'm just picking on captains, that's all. Let's see what we can do here.
I mean, we can, you know, duo and see what happens.
Yeah, I'm terrible at dueling, so you'd probably win. I don't have any doubt about it. Alright, we'll start with thievery and mischief. Oh, I'm in an instance, so I can't do it from here. I forgot. Let's go anywhere else but here. Food acquired. Mort is no longer hungry. That is good news. We are trying to keep it classy, Cervantes, I promise. Now the next time I log in Galandriel, I'm going to be like, what am I doing in Rivendell? Look at that view. Look at how spectacular that is. You can just see the waterfalls cascading everywhere. Just love the view of Rivendell. The last homely house off in the distance. Yeah, I've got the graphics turned up. This is another one of those take a look at this kind of things. Blow the stream up full screen. Take a look at what Lotro looks like at 1080p ultra high detail. It's pretty gorgeous. Instances.
Halls of Crafting.
I've been through Halls of Crafting a bunch.
While war raged in the south and the rangers of the north were absent, brigands and ruffians took an opportunity to wrest control of Bree.
I mean, if there was any point for me in the hall to be in the Halls of Crafting at all, I'd be happy to do it, but South Gate has been cleared. Hello, Hail Captain. Why are you picking on my herbalist? That's just wrong. Brother of Destruction Slayer. I was gonna say, I don't recall seeing those before. Counterattack has been repressed.
Alright, brother. Have a good afternoon. I gotta roll.
Yeah, have fun at the pool party, man. Talk to you later.
Lady snuck in here being very quiet.
Yeah, why'd you want me to do the crafting halls when you weren't going to stick around to watch anyway?
Have fun!
Bye! He was baiting me. And as long as we're talking about Alapenya and Mortumbra and Maiden of Rohan, all three of them are also on Lotro's stream. So if you haven't had a chance to follow them previously, all you have to do is left-click on their name in chat. It'll pull up the dialog box here on Twitch, and you can just click follow. That way you'll know the next time they're on and streaming live. Claim the auction hall. I guess everything's cleared off, or it wouldn't be letting me claim the auction hall. You're gonna counterattack, let's get on with it. Is 800 silver excessive for a high-grade Rittermark ingot? If you just need one ingot, you can go get Rittermark Skarn in about 10 seconds. Wildermore is loaded with it, and if you can get to... what's the capital? Probably still have a tag for it somewhere. Forlaw. If you've got the return to Forlaw travel trait, you can just walk outside of Forlaw and start picking up all of the Rittermark Skarn you want. In fact, it actually is pretty good auction house bait. When I've been short on cash in the past, I've gone out and collected Rittermark Skarn just to sell. Because it's just one of those mid to high level type crafting materials that, you know, people use it up and they don't want to go out and farm it anymore, so they're happy to pay for it. Usually pretty brings a pretty big chunk. Leech Warden. Come here, Leech Warden. I would like to do very bad things to you with my sword. Take a knee, Leech Warden. Will only hurt while you're still alive. Trying to sell 30 ingots. Well, if you're trying to sell them, then no. Like I said, people pay plenty for them. Don't be afraid to ask the moon. Somebody out there would rather buy your ingots than have to go all the way out to Forlaw and mine. And if you want cash, like I said, that's a really good thing to put in the auction house. So you're looking for, what, like 25 gold for 30 ingots, basically? That's not cheap, but somebody may pay it. I wouldn't be surprised. Oh, a bunch of people undercut you at the auction house. That's weird. I hadn't noticed that there was a lot of competition to sell Rittermark's Garn. Tukar, did you have something to say, Tukar? Let's fight. One thing I hate more than anything, it's getting interrupted in the middle of ferocious strikes. Tukar did not survive. I feel bad for Tukar. Perfect. Where are you going? Guess we'll all fight here then. Yeah, it's weird, Omega Femme. I don't know why somebody would be undercutting you. I would think demand would be high enough that everybody should be able to sell all of the ore they want at a pretty high market price. Jailhouse has been cleared. Guys got a counterattack for me? There we go. Deathmonger. Oh, I have to kill him right away. Deathmongers, if you kill one of the people they're fighting with, will recall them as evil spirits and you get to fight them again. So, best to go ahead and pop them right away. A raspy voice sounds from the northwest. Where is it? Where did it go? Northwest should be further on up ahead. Keep an eye out for that other encounter. I must be looking for Snagburrs. Come here, Snagburrs. Let's you and me have a talk. Take a knee, Snagburrs. There you go. Snagburrs did not make it. This way? Yep, Bear of Blight. Courtyard has been cleared. I think I have gotten blown up here. There's an Isengard bid, 5 mem going around in world chat. It's been happening for weeks. Isengard bids 5, yeah. I normally do better selling the raw ore than I ever have ingots. Sometimes people like the ore just to boost their prospecting. Alright, hopefully I managed not to screw this up. Why would you kill that dude? That was just mean. Apparently I want to stay out of the middle there? I don't know. Did not make it. There you go, take a knee. He did not make it. And see if there's anything good in the chest. Nope. Marks, medallions. 16 pieces of silver. Oh, I did get one gold coin, 995 silver. Okay, well that didn't suck. At least it was decent money. Hello, Second Watcher Heathstraw. Yeah, the updates that they did when they added the DirectX 11 features was really nice. Fire 2 looks a lot better with DirectX 11 turned on. So, alright. Boy, we got 30 people in stream. This is the most I've had watching me for a little while. So, I just heard Mrs. Mustafa walk back through the door. I believe she has lunch. And it is a beautiful day here, so I need to get outside and go do something. When I first started streaming this morning, I didn't see anybody else playing Lotro. I do not see anybody playing Lotro now. So I will throw this out there. If Mortumbra or Maiden of Rohan or anybody else on Lotro stream wants to jump on official, I'm about to hop off. I don't have anybody that I can kick this channel over to at the moment, so even if you just wanted to host on your own channel, fire it up and I will be happy to send the folks over to you. Otherwise, I'm just going to go ahead and have to turn the stream off for now. And I want to thank everybody who came out to watch this morning. We've had a good crowd and just enjoyed adventuring and chatting with you guys while I was kicking around doing my Minas Tirith dailies. But like I said, the main reason to stream this game is to show it off to the world. Lotro is beautiful, and it's still lively, and there's lots of cool stuff to see and do. And, you know, there's plenty of games within games. Player versus Monster Player is a game almost unto itself. You know, raiding and six-man instances is almost an entirely different game than solo play. Solo play is very vibrant. There's tons and tons and tons of content to explore. 9 or 10 different character classes. So, you are welcome, Dazon and Ninth Pawn. Happy to stream. Had a lot of fun. But if you're in chat and you haven't played Lotro before, or you haven't played Lotro for a long time, you know, check it out. The game's free to play. You can download the game client at lotro.com. And it looks beautiful, and it's fun to play, and it's not a pay-to-win model. Like I said, I'm free to play. I've never been VIP, and to the best of my knowledge, I don't recall ever spending any of my own money on the game. You know, if you build a couple of crafting circles on a couple of different servers and level them up together, you'll make so many turbine points from deeds and quest completions. You'll be able to buy the expansions as you get ready for them. You'll be able to buy the add-on content and the quest packs. And, you know, you don't have to pay if you're willing to put in the time. If you do want to pay or you don't have the time to devote to grinding the turbine points, it's still very reasonable. $10 a month if you buy it 3 months at a time. Usually towards the end of the year, Turbine will even do an annual for $79 or $99, which is cheaper yet. VIP gives you 500 turbine points a month. VIP gives you mail anywhere in the world. VIP gives you swift travel, so you don't have to ride on stable master's horses forever and ever. It's money well spent, especially if you like the game and you've got more money than time. You know, $10, it's not a big deal. You know, you can rent two bad movies, or you can get a whole month's worth of LOTRO VIP for that. So, far more entertaining than sitting through a Dwayne The Rock Johnson movie at this point in his career. But thanks for coming out and watching. I'm still waiting for anybody to pop up and say, I'm going to stream LOTRO, Ed. Kick him over to me. Hasn't happened yet, so you guys have a great weekend. The Seven Hero is going to be streaming here tomorrow. I believe it's 7 to 10 Eastern, so that's 6 p.m. to 9 Central. Be sure to check that out. And, you know, we've revamped the streamer schedule. There's tons of great people on LOTRO Stream, myself the least of which, but there's always something lively going on over here. And to folks like Nettlebrew and to the Fudginator, you know, if you're interested in streaming LOTRO, there's always room for more LOTRO streamers. You know, the dream is to have 20 of us all streaming at the same time and have, you know, 50 or 100 people in everybody's chat all at the same time. And we're not going to get there unless we build the streamer base. So if you want to try streaming, LOTRO is a great game to stream. And anybody who is streaming LOTRO already will probably be happy to give you help and advice. You know, Eldolith did wonders getting my Moobot configured for me. We kind of help each other out and answer questions all the time. So just reach out to one of us if you want to get your own stream started. And who knows, if you stick around long enough, you might find yourself on LOTRO Stream in a few months helping us fill up the roster. So thanks, Shoto Elite. Glad you liked the stream. If you guys want, I would appreciate a follow on my personal channel. I'm going to type it in chat. It is twitch.tv/BigEdMustafa. No surprise there. And pop over and give me a follow. Hopefully you guys got a chance to give Maiden and All Up and Mortumbra follows earlier. But, you know, there's lots of good LOTRO streamers. I'm always happy to get on and chat with folks. There are people who do stuff that I don't do in-game that are really interesting to watch. Bloodborne comes to mind if you're up later at night. He does a lot of group content, a lot of raids, a lot of six-man and 12-man stuff. You know, Andrew Allstars loves player versus monster player. Loves to play in the Moors, loves to play Freeps, likes to play Creeps. I'm in his new creep kinship here on Arkenstone called Rivendell's Most Wanted. Ironic, since I'm standing in Rivendell, but I'm not here on my orc. So that's fun to watch. Come check the guys out. And everybody have a great weekend. If I don't see you real soon in my stream, hopefully I'll be able to catch you in yours. Bye-bye. And that was Del7. Thank you for the follow. Appreciate it, and have a great weekend.